careful with the front wing, you've taken some minor damage. Okay, take it easy on the car. We can't sustain this level of damage.
And with qualifying complete, let's review our top three today.
Bottas, Hamilton,
and Lando Norris. With qualifying wrapped up, we now have our grid line up for the big race tomorrow. Be sure to join us then. Fourth row start is just about as likely to give you a podium as a pole position would. And remember, in 2017 and 2018, both Lance Stroll and then Sergio Perez took surprise podiums here.
It's 3.7 miles around a lap of Baku City Circuit then, with 7 rights and 13 lefts, giving us a total of 20 corners. Watch out for the safety car today. Incidents are already common on this circuit, and the wet conditions will only make things worse, particularly through the incredibly narrow Turn 8.
It's not going to be plain sailing for our drivers today, although with the sky falling as it is, perhaps sailing isn't too far from the truth. Anthony Davidson, could be a wet one today. Great to have you with us. What are your thoughts?
It is a touch damp, isn't it? Well, as a driver, there are three big things to worry about when racing in these kind of conditions. Standing water, tyre temperature and visibility. Judging distance to the cars around you is really tricky when you're driving through the vast amounts of spray that these wet weather Pirelli tyres kick up.
It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position, edging out Lando Norris, who'll start from P2. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Verstappen, Ricciardo, Sebastian Vettel, and Perez, Stroll, Leclerc, Moore, and Pierre Gasly, Bottas, Sainz, Fernando Alonso, and Ocon, Raikkonen, Giovinazzi, Mick Schumacher,
and George Russell, Mazepin and Nicholas Latifi. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
Nice move. Good job. Safety car is out. We need you to reduce your pace. It looks like there's a high amount of debris on the track. Drop yours. Okay, let's get ready to go racing again. The safety car is in this lap. When the field accelerates, remember, there is no overtaking until the green flags. Safety car in this lap. Okay, we lost the position. Try to keep focus. There's been an incident on track, but officials aren't looking to push for a safety car right now. Just be careful.
As they climb out of the car, the Red Bull team are ready and waiting to celebrate a thoroughly well-deserved win. Anthony Davidson, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
Well, this was a real team victory. They put together a solid strategy today that appeared well suited to the conditions out on track. The driver did everything that was expected of them in the moment to really execute the team's plan to perfection, a shining example of how F1 really is a team sport.
Red Bull are our winners today after showcasing some incredible driving. There's been a huge push from them lately to stay competitive with the other teams, and they're certainly proving themselves. driver standings have changed. Not the result our points leader wanted, but it certainly makes things interesting going forward. Some amazing talent out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
Let's give it to Esteban Ocon. That was a commanding performance today. Very impressive indeed.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. No change in the top spot, but with today's points, their hold on the lead is getting weaker. Meanwhile, Ferrari have improved their position. A strong weekend from them as they fight their way towards the top. I'm equal parts exhausted and elated with this weekend of Formula 1.
Okay, we've had the new parts come through the fabrication process. We'll have them with us for the next Grand Prix.